Hi students, welcome back to geography class. Here I'm showing this video, especially chapter 1 question answers. Yesterday I already sent one video clip PDF. I think everybody got that answers. Anyway, for better clarification, here I'm showing your all answers. What are the answers you want to write? The brief answers and detailed answers. According to that, you want to make one copy for the geography and maintain, keep with you. Okay, all these answers you want to write in your copy. Okay, let us start. Here, the first question: what do topographical maps show? Topographical maps are large scale maps that show both the natural features such as mountains, hills, rivers, plateaus, ridges, etc., and human man-made features such as roads, railway tracks, temples, bridges, buildings. This already I given before. Okay, the next questions you can see. What is contour line? These all answers I already shown before the videos. Anyway, a contour line is an imaginary line on a map connecting points at the same height above sea level. You should draw the diagram also. You already, I think, drawn. Once again, you drawn in your copy. And see the next question, third question. Distinguish vertical interval and horizontal equivalent. The difference in height between two adjacent contour lines. You already study the steep slopes and gentle slopes. And it is known as vertical interval. Whereas distance between any two adjacent contour lines is called horizontal equivalent or HE. The horizontal equivalent is calculated with the help of scale or the map. The value of the HE is less when the slope is steep and more when the slope is gentle. And now we can move to the next question. What is a ridge? How do you identify a ridge on a topo sheet? This diagram also already I given before. Anyway, here you can see the answers. A ridge is a long and narrow elevation that has steep slopes on either side and stands out from surrounding lowlands, steep slopes. It also acts as a watershed to rivers that flow down narrow valley on both of its sides. A ridge could also have several peaks or various elevation. You can see continuous ranges, peaks, various elevations. On a topo sheet, the contours of ridge are oval with the contour close to each other, indicating the steepness. Okay, how much steep? Ridges usually you can see steep slopes. Now we can move the next question. What is a saddle? Draw a diagram to show a saddle. A saddle is a shallow depression at a high elevation between two peaks or ridges. The depression is formed by streams or by glaciers flowing close to each other. A saddle need not have a river or stream flowing through it. A saddle is a shallow depression at a high elevation between two peaks or ridges. The depression is formed by streams by glaciers flowing close to each other. A saddle need not have a river or stream flowing through it. Diagram is here. You should draw the diagram. And next question, what is a linear settlement? Where would you normally find a linear settlement? You already studied before three types of settlements. This is one of the settlement, linear settlements. Linear settlements are those settlements that develop in a line, houses, shops, dabas, petrol pumps, garages developed along the sides of roads, railway lines, or river banks. Gradually, these linear settlements grow in size. These settlements gradually develop into trading centers. Example, if such a settlement is near a railway track and over a period of time, a need of railway station is felt, then it will become no doubt a railway stop or railway station. Hence, located on a main road, such as settlements become important stops for travelers and dhabas. Or sometime you can see the tire and car repairing shops and petrol pumps open up. It will slowly develop that region. And third point, you can see on rivers and coasters, they become places where boats can unload goods and passengers. This area also slowly become linear settlements. I think everybody understood. The seventh question. Next question, how would you recognize a metal road and unmetal road on one topographical map? Before already you study that metal roads, no, non-metal road usually given in red color, solid lines. No, metal roads are shown by red solid lines, whereas unmetal road is shown by dotted red lines. Anyway, with the red lines you can see metal road and unmetal road. Vehicles such as trucks, buses, cars, jeeps and other modern means of transport move over metal roads. There are also car tracks, pack tracks, footpaths, which are unmetal roads. Car tracks, pack tracks connect to small villages. You know, you all knowing that unmetal road showing the undeveloped region. Unmetal roads showing means it is almost a developed region. Okay, metal road you can see in city and town, and unmetal road you can see the village area. Now we can move to the detailed answer, long answers. Okay, this long answers also you want to write in your copy. First question, what is a cliff and how can we identify it on a topo sheet? And also you want to draw the diagram, show the cliff. A cliff is a vertical or near vertical land feature, and the landform rises vertically from the lower ground. On a contour map, the contour lines are very close together or merge into a single line. In other words, contour lines overlap. This indicates a cliff. Already I told before, explain also, one side sea or ocean is there. From the sea or oceans, the rocky region, steep slopes were there. And this feature is known as the cliff. Now we can move to the, no, I think you can see the diagram properly here. Downside also you want to draw this cliff. Okay, both side you want to draw. And the next question, how is waterfall form? Okay, waterfall. You all knowing waterfall, where you can see the waterfall, the first stage and second stage of the river. River stages, sixth class you already study the first stage, middle stage, upper stage, middle stage and lower stage. Here you can see a waterfall is formed when there is a sudden drop in the river valley. It is like a cliff where the drop is almost perpendicular. Waterfalls are formed in the upper regions of river valleys when contours on map are very close to one another or sometimes touch each other. As they cross a river or stream, it indicates the presence of a waterfall. You know, the top of the mountains from where the rivers are starting, and the first stage of the river, and there you can see the waterfall diagram also you want to show. And this diagram contour lines, you can see steep slopes were there. Okay, steep slopes. Now we can move to the next question. Where are V-shaped valleys and U-shaped valleys formed, and how can these we can identify on the topo sheet. Everybody know, I already told, you know, about the upper stage, middle stage and lower stage. V-shaped valley, there is no doubt, it you can see on the first stage or upper stage of the river. V-shaped valleys are found in the upper course of a river, where the slopes on either side of the river are steep. You know, from where the river start, that region you can see V-shaped valley. Contour lines are usually highly steep slopes. A V-shaped valley is easily identified on a contour map with the contour lines close to each other. Contour lines close to each other means there is no doubt it is a steep valley, okay, steep slopes, and very dominant V-shape. Diagram you can see dominant V-shape. Okay, here it is the diagram showing properly, both diagram you want to draw in your copy. And the middle course or lower course, middle and the last lower course, you can see U-shaped valleys. U-shaped valleys, how it form, you know, because of the weathering and erosion. U-shaped valleys are found in regions where the action of ice, melting ice, glaciers has widened the valley so that the valleys take the shape of a U shape. These are also found in lower regions of a river, where the erosion of valley falls by the river widens and the valleys to make them look like a U shape. The contour lines of these valleys are bent in shape. Okay, bend in shape. U shape valleys always showing in U shape. Okay, we can move to the next question. What are the different factors that determine the location and the type of settlements? The first class about the settlements, I told you that time already I given what are the factors determine the location and type of settlements. Anyway, here I am repeat. Okay, settlements, the first points you can see, settlements grow in areas that are flat and where the land is cultivatable, you know. Settlements do not grow on steep hillsides or marshy lands. Already I given one example, northern plains. Okay, and the second point is, settlements grow in place where water is available in plenty for both agricultural and domestic purposes. Settlements therefore also grow on confluence of rivers of the banks of rivers. You all knowing that the availability of the water very important. Okay, without water people don't want to continuously stay in one place. Water is very important for the settlements. Third point, settlements also thrive on a plateau. Before I given one example, Deccan Plateau. It is a flat surface and also very fertile for the cultivation of the crops. Okay, availability of the flat surface of the land. Then next, fourth point, they develop and grow in places where the climate is suitable or pleasant to live in. Extremely hot like Rajasthan and extremely cold like Jammu and Kashmir region. Jammu and Kashmir region, sometimes people are ready to live. But very cold region like Arctic Circle or Antarctic Circle, people don't want to live because the climate is not pleasant. While Bangalore, you know, in India, Bangalore, a pleasant climate. Everybody like to live. Next, settlements are formed where there are prospectus for employment, facility of the employment, okay, availability of the job facilities. Mines, near the mines, no, an industrial area also people like to live. These are the potential source of employment and encourage growth of settlements. Such places are usually near places of the abundant raw materials. Okay, wherever abundant raw materials, near that places you can see people like to settle. Calcutta, Mumbai High, you know, Tamil Nadu, and some other places you can see availability of the raw material and also job facilities. Next points we can continue. They develop in places that are easily accessible by various kinds of transportation. Okay, availability of the transportations, there is no doubt. the development always depends upon railway tracks, roads, you know, airport. The same way, settlements always depends upon near the roads, near the riverside, railway lines, easy access to, and form the settlements will allow movement of people and goods, services from one place to another. I think all these factors you already understood before we discuss also. Now, we can move to the fifth question answer. How can transport and communication on an area be inferred directly from topographical map sheet? No, there is no doubt. Transportation and communication is very, very important for the settlements, you know. And here on the top of sheet, how you can find out. It is very easy to find out with the black lines. No, on the top of sheet, you can see the with the black lines cross on the map. That is indicating the communications and transportations. On a topographical map, you will notice some black lines that cross the map. These lines are symbols or roadways and railway tracks, indicates the type of communication in the area. They depict the various modes of transport and transportation being used in the area. Some places you can see broad gauge is there, meter gauge is there, no, and also narrow gauge. According to that, easy to understand it is developed region or underdeveloped region. Okay, with the black line, with the black lines that cross on the map showing the communication and the transportations. Okay, when many roads and railway lines converge in village or town, it indicates the importance of a place, that area no doubt highly developed. It could be for several reasons, such as the economic activity of the region, or the region could be tourist, no, region of tourist destination, hotspot, or it could be because of the presence of industries and factories leading to plenty of job opportunities. And near the airports, airports are also an important form of travel and communications, but airports are confined to large cities only. The conventional signs of an aeroplane indicates the presence of an airport or airstrip. There is no doubt the airports were there means that region is highly developed. Okay, now I think all detailed answers completed. Picture study is there. With this picture study, you can complete your copy. Okay, now we can move to the picture study. You should draw these diagrams, okay? These boxes with the red color. You already study settlements usually used in red squares. Before also linear settlements I shown, that also you want to draw with the red squares, okay? Not black squares, red squares, okay? Instead of the black, you want to draw red squares and filled with the red color. Identify the type of settlement shown in the picture. There is no doubt, you already study, it is a nucleated settlements, clusters. You study before previous class, like a clusters of the stars. Okay, this is a nucleated settlements. Okay, now we can move to the next question. Two characteristics of this type of settlements. What are the main features? Linear settlements. Linear settlements are those settlements that develop in a line. Houses, shops, dabas, petrol pumps and garages develop along the sides of the roads, railway lines or river banks. Gradually these line settlements grow in size. These settlements gradually develop into trading centers, no doubt. Near linear settlements gradually to develop a trading centers. Example, if such a settlement is linear railway track, no, near the railway track, and over a period of time, no doubt, in need for railway station, it will change into railway station. Okay, then next point you can see when located on main roads. Okay, this linear settlement is located near the road, such as settlements become important stops for travelers, dabas, tire and car repairing shops, petrol pumps. So always like that only, gradually it develop. Okay, then on rivers and coastal region, sometime linear settlements you can see near the rivers and coastal region. They become places where boats can unload goods and passengers. Slowly, gradually, no doubt, this area also become a linear settlements. Okay, I think everybody understood here also. You want to draw this diagram with the red squares. Now we can move to scattered settlements. Scattered settlements, they are also known as dispersed settlements, because houses here and there only, not clusters, okay? Like linear settlements and nuclear settlements, here houses are here and there. Houses or huts in this type of settlements are far apart from one another. On a map, such a settlement is indicated by long distances between houses. Such areas show sparse population and the absence of proper roads. Houses or huts are usually connected by car tracks or paths. It is not that much highly developed. And also this regions, maybe some problem is there. Lack of water, unpleasant climate, and the surface of the land is not flat, not fertile soil. And usually this side of the people, depends upon cattle rearing. It is a common as each household. And it has cattle that is allowed to graze in the open fields. The land is not very fertile to support big population. Here also you want to draw these squares with the red color. Okay, scattered settlements. Now we can move to, already given the previous video, let us do something. Those students till now did not do, once again I am giving the chance, okay. Here I am giving the diagram. These diagrams are not that much clear, means you can use the before files, clips, okay. And the first diagram, no doubt you already, we already discuss, you know, these diagrams. First one is a ridge, okay. And the second diagram showing a conical hill. Second diagram showing a conical hill. And the third diagram showing a saddle, and a fourth it is a plateau. Then this is a gap in between two mountains. One gap is there. Through the gap people can move from one place to another place. Then pass also almost like a gap, okay. The ranges of the hills and mountains, between the hills and mountains you can see the valleys, okay. These are the diagrams given in the last page of your book, and some extra questions also given in yesterday's video. Those students interested, they can write in your copy. Otherwise till here this diagram also included, you should complete in your copy, okay. I think everybody understood these answers. Okay, thank you.